Hey guys, this is Balu from Balu Prime and once again welcome you all back for an exciting tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see how we can create this skull breaking animation inside Blender easily. So I hope you will find this tutorial useful, but before going to that, if you end up liking this video, please click on that like button to share this content, and if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing my channel and support me. So further without any ado, let's begin. So here you can see I'm using Blender 2.90. Nice. Now let's select everything in this default scene and delete it. So in order to select everything, press A on the keyboard and delete. Now let's import our 3D model here. So in order to do that, go to this file options, click on that file, import. So here I got a skull model which is in OBJ format. So I will be selecting this wavefront.obj. And by the way, I have provided a download link in the description where you can download the same model which I am using in this tutorial. So now let's select that model, click on this wavefront. So here I got this skull model in object format and import OBJ. So we got our model here, but it is way big. Now let's reduce the scaling of it. So further press S on the keyboard and simply drag your mouse left side to reduce the scaling. Now press 3 on the keyboard for side view. Select this rotate tool and rotate model here in this way. Now select this move tool and let's move it down over here. Nice, fine. So now let's select this model, come to this material properties. Let's see whether it got some texture. So it got some textures here. So if we go to this material viewport, you can see that textures are already present on this model. So let's change the look of this. So scroll down, let's increase this metallic like 0.787 and let's reduce the roughness here like this so that our model starts to look like metal. Okay, so it looks better. Now let's move back to this solid viewport. Now select your model, come to this modify properties, add modifier and add this solidify modifier. So by adding this modifier, we'll get the fractures or pieces aligned properly once the fracture process is done. So without applying this solidify modifier, we may not get the fractured pieces properly aligned. So it's better to apply this solidify modifier and increase this thickness to like 0.1 and change this offset to positive 1 so that thickness will be added outwards, and come to this normals and check this high quality. Nice. So once this is done, now let's enable cell fracture add-on. So to do that, go to this edit preferences, come to this add-on and in search box search cell CLL. So it will be unchecked. Check it means enable it. Click on these three lines here and select save preferences. So we can close this now. Now select this model. Let's apply this modifier to this. Just click on this drop down here and apply it. So after applying this modifier, go to this object, quick effects and select cell fracture. So here you can see the source limit is by default set to 100. That means we'll get 100 pieces here. So I don't want 100 pieces. So I want this to be of only 15. Number is of your choice. You can choose either 200, 500, 1000. Depends on you. So I'll be leaving this to 15. And shattered pieces, I'll select this random. Select this random and hit OK. So we got our model shattered into pieces. Nice. Now select this skull main model. Let's move it sideward and delete. Okay. Now select any one fractured piece. So let me select this fractured piece here. Come to this physics properties, click on this physics properties and apply rigid body. Type, let it be active. Mass, let it be 1 kg. So now let's apply this physics properties to other remaining materials. So let's press A on the keyboard, go to object, rigid body and select copy from active. So now each and every piece got this physics, that means rigid body applied. So if you select this piece, you can see it got this rigid body. So if we play this animation, we can see that all the pieces are falling down. So we don't want that. So let's add some obstacle or a ground plane to this scene. So go to this add mesh, select plane. Now press S on the keyboard and increase the scaling here. Okay. Now select the plane, apply this rigid body. Now type, change it to passive. So now if we play this, we can see that the particles or fractured particles are not falling down. So now let's apply some material onto this plane. Already some material is present on the skull model, so let's apply some material onto this plane. So let's move to this material port, click on this shading button, click on this material properties, add new material and change it to, where is this, diffuse, change to diffuse. So we got these nodes here. Now let's add few nodes. So click on this add input and select texture coordinate, place it here, add. Now let's add mapping, come to this vector and select mapping, place it here. Now come to this add texture and select image texture. Okay, now connect UV of texture coordinate to vector of mapping. Now connect vector of mapping to vector of image texture, color of image texture to diffuse color. Okay, so now we can select any image or texture that will be applied onto this plane. So let's select this. So here I got a few textures already, so let me select one of the wood texture which is available. So let me change this to thumbnail. So let me select this one and open. So you can see we got that wood texture applied. Okay, now let's move back to this layout. Now come to this render properties. So here I will be using this EV engine. If you want, you can use cycles. So if I go to this cycles, but before do that, let's go to this world properties, click on this color icon and add environment texture. Click on this open button and select HDRI image. So here I got few HDRI images which I have downloaded from HDRI Heaven. So I will be using this photo studio. So select that one and open image. So if I click on this rendered viewport, you can see that studio lighting is applied in the scene. Fine. Now come to this render properties. If you want to use EV, you can use, or else you can use cycles also. If I use cycles, you can see that difference here. It will be much better when compared to EV, but rendering will take a lot of time. And suppose if you are using cycles, make sure to enable GPU compute if your device supports GPU. That helps to render fast. So I will move back to EV. So now enable this ambient occlusion, expand this and increase the distance here. So you can observe, if I increase this ambient distance, we are getting this nice ambient applied all over the scene. So I think this would be better. Scroll down and enable this screen space reflections. You can see the difference by applying this, enabling this option. So make sure to enable this screen space reflection. Nice. Now scroll down, come to this film. I want this transparent background. So check this transparent. Lighting will be there, but background will be transparent. It looks better. Nice. So if we play this animation, we can see we got this nice animation here. So now let's convert this animation into keyframes. So in order to do that, first hide out this plane, just hide out the plane. Now press A on the keyboard to select everything other than plane. Make sure that plane is not selected and go to this object, rigid body, and select bake to keyframes. So here we can select start frame and end frame. So ending frame I will be selecting this to 150 and hit OK. So this may take time depending upon number of keyframes you have selected here. So once this process is done, now let's see this, just move it here. So here you can see this whole animation is converted or baked into keyframes. If you're not seeing this keyframes, come to this view, click on this view and hide out this only keyframes here. So you will get the keyframes visible in this timeline. So let's select all the keyframes. Press G on the keyboard and let's move it here like this, because we don't want this animation to start from the beginning only. So if you play this, it will be steady and after some time the fracture pieces will break down. So we can do one other thing also, we can slow down a bit. So I think okay, this second frame. Now deselect everything, just click on this blank area. Now select all the keyframes except these both keyframes here. Press G on the keyboard and simply bring some gap between these keyframes. So if we play this, you can see there is small slow animation here. So in this way, if we want to increase the speed or decrease the speed, like slow motion if you want, you can do by converting the animation into keyframes. So let's press Z, let's bring it close. Okay, nice, fine. So let's bring back our solid plane. Nice. Okay, so let's move back to this first keyframe. So now let's add camera in this scene. So go to this add, click on this add button and select camera. Now press Ctrl Alt 0, press N on the keyboard, come to this view, click on this view and select this camera to view. Now we can adjust the position of the scene here. Okay, so let's add some camera rotation for this scene. So in order to do that, let's first be on this first frame, go to this add empty and select this cube. Now press S on the keyboard, increase the scaling. Okay, just increase the scaling. So in scene collection, first select empty, hold shift key and select camera. Now press Ctrl P, press Ctrl P and select object keep transform. So now if we change this Z value, you can see we are getting this rotation animation. So let's bring it 0. So make sure you are at first frame. Press I on the keyboard and select this rotation. So we got a keyframe added for rotation. Now let's move to 200 frame. Now change the rotation value here like this. Okay, fine. And press I on the keyboard once again and select rotation. Okay, so now if we play this animation, you can see we got this rotation added into our scene. So once the keyframes are added, now select only those rotation keyframes, not these animation keyframes. Make sure these animation keyframes are not selected. Select only rotation keyframes, click here and change it to graph editor. Okay, now click on this key interpolation mode and select linear. Okay, now let's change back to this 3D viewport. Let's change back to this timeline, right? Yeah, timeline. Okay, so now if we play this animation, we will get equal speed. Or else let's do one thing, let's delete these keyframes once again. Delete these keyframes, let me animate it here like this. So press I, add rotation keyframe, move to this, I think, okay, move to this 200 frame, rotate it, slow rotation, and press I, select rotation. Nice. So I got this slow rotation here. So once this is done, now let's move to this rendering portion. So here we have selected this EV engine to render. Now move to this output properties. Here by default it is set to full HD. I will be leaving it to that. If you are using Blender 2.9 version, make sure to check this render region. I think in previous version this is not there, not sure, but check this render region option. And frame, here I will be selecting like 200. Frame rate, you can select here. I will be leaving this to 24. Output folder, let me select. Output folder selected. In file format, now this time I will be rendering into video format only. So select this MPEG video. Okay. Now come to this encoding, expand this encoding. Here in container, let me select this MPEG-4, or else you can use AVA also. Here I will be using this MPEG-4 and video codec H.264. I think this is fine. Output quality, lossless, encoding speed, let it be good. Okay, so once this is done, come to this render and start render animation. So in this way we can create this skull breaking animation in Blender easily. So I hope you guys have learned something new from this tutorial. So we'll meet in the next video. Until then, signing off, take care, bye.